Welcome to another GBC tutorial. I am Ufuma Ogaga, owner of Goshen Bookkeeping and Consulting. In this tutorial, I will address one of the questions I get asked by clients, which is, how do I see a report in QuickBooks Online that will show me the list of transactions that have not cleared my bank accounts? The report you need is called Uncleared Bank Transactions Report. This report will show you any outstanding checks and or transactions that have cleared your bank accounts. QuickBooks Online does not have the Uncleared Bank Transaction Reports as one of the standard ones. You have to customize it using a balance sheet report, which is also known as a Statement of Financial Position Report if you are a nonprofit organization. Let's switch to QuickBooks Online so that I can show you how to create this report. This is my QuickBooks Online sample file. In here, I am going to click the Reports tab, then select Standard Reports. In this Standard Report screen, you can scroll down to find the Balance Sheet or Statement of Financial Position Report. My own is already listed as a favorite report here, so I am going to click on it to open it. This is what a typical balance sheet report looks like, so I am going to make a few changes to customize this report to get the uncleared bank transactions report that we need. The first thing to do is to change this report period to all dates, change the accounting method to cash base, then click run report. So we need to see uncleared transactions for all bank accounts, so I will click on the total bank line to open a transaction detail report. This report shows all of the transactions that have been processed throughout the years for all of my bank accounts. I am going to customize this report to only show my uncleared transactions. To do this, I will click the Customize button at the top right corner of the page to open the Customize screen. Here I am going to choose the option to show negative numbers in red and in parentheses. Expand the filter option, then scroll down to find and click on CLED. In the drop-down option for the CLED filter, I am going to select uncleared and collapse the filter. I will expand the header section, then change the report title to uncleared bank transactions. I will also uncheck the boxes for date prepared and time prepared. Once done, I will click on the green Run Report button to run this report. So this is how the report looks like. To customize it further, I can group or sort the report by any of the displayed columns and click Run Report to see the changes. I love customizing my reports by grouping or sorting them by the name of the vendor. So I am going to choose that option and click Run Report again. Once done, I will save this report so that it's easier for me to come into QuickBooks Online and run the report at any given time without having to repeat all of the steps that we just did. So to do this, I will click on the Save Customize button at the top, and I'm going to just leave it as the default because QuickBooks is automatically picking up the name. Once you save the report, it will be stored under the Reports tab. To see the custom reports tab, I am going to click back to report list. Here is the report that we just created. I can email this report to somebody else by clicking on the edit button and select a schedule for the report to be sent out to the person on a monthly basis. I am not going to do this, so I will exit out of this screen. Coming back to the report screen, and by clicking on the drop-down arrow next to the edit button, I can export the report to PDF or Excel. Now you have a report to follow up with your vendors to find out if a replacement check needs to be issued or to figure out why a transaction did not clear your bank accounts. Check out my blog for more QuickBooks Online tips. Thank you for watching.